certain toughness inside of Tyson Fury. Don't ever listen to me, Tyson. Everyone says he's all pretty, just that. But I know him personally. He's lived with Ben Mahomes, too. And he's stayed with me. I've trained Latimer. I've hit them all together. He is maybe the toughest. With his natural talent and his engaging personality and his physical size, he's going to be a big, big, big factor in boxing. I've always felt that after Latimer, he's going to be the next dominant heavyweight. But there's one kid in America that no one speaks of, and that's Deontay Wilder. He was on the Olympic team. He lost it, the big kid. And I've had the fortune of, he's came and trained with me before, too. And he's a big kid. He's bigger than Latimer, too. But he's got good speed and power. And I think best talent is still going to be Tyson and Deontay Wilder.
Welcome to another edition of IMO Sports with Pedro Justice. Deontay Wilder and Tyson Fury are still getting it on this November or December. And I know that's hurting people's feelings because they wanted Anthony Joshua to get the first crack at Tyson Fury. But it's not going to happen because Deontay Wilder wanted a fight with AJ, and AJ did not want to fight with Deontay Wilder, because if he did, they would not have offered a flat fee. I'm not letting that go because it's the truth. And you're going to have to swallow this pill that a flat fee has never happened in a title fight with champion versus champion. Please, someone tell me that I'm lying. Anyways, Deontay Wilder and Tyson Fury are still fighting. Tyson Fury is coming off of a 3-year layoff due to you know what. And now he's had 2 fights 3 months apart to get back in shape. And he's definitely worked hard, because if you saw him when he was first came back until now, you can definitely tell the difference. And so when the Deontay Wilder fight comes around, he's going to be much slimmer and fitter, so that he'll be able to try to execute what he wanted to. So I did show that Steve Cunningham dropped him with an overhand right in 2013. And so that's 5 years ago. He still got caught with an overhand right. So if he gets caught by Deontay Wilder's overhand right, or straight right, or anything like that, it would be no different, because now he should be smarter. But people are going to say that he would be faster. And if you see this fight, he wasn't fast. Tyson Fury is never going to be fast. So I don't know what fighter they're talking about. Tyson Fury has always been awkward. He has quick hands for his size, but he's never been fast or have exciting fights. So that's not the problem. Now, I did think he was going to have at least 4 fights when he came back. But I think by now he's been boxing long enough to know himself and know that it's just a formality. Now that I really need a challenge in order to see who's the best Tyson Fury. Who's the best Tyson Fury inside of myself? And Manny Stewart said, guess what? Tyson Fury is a tough guy. Tyson Fury adjusts to whoever he's fighting. He wants him to fight his fight. Now, what Deontay Wilder has to do is not allow Tyson Fury to lull him to sleep with that awkward style. Deontay Wilder has to use that jab and enforce whatever skills that he has continued to gain. He needs to do that in the fight and pressure him. He needs to be smart, because Tyson Fury is not the biggest knockout puncher, but he does have heavy hands, and he will use his forearms or whatever he needs to gain an advantage. So Deontay Wilder has to keep an eye on that. As far as Deontay Wilder's, he has a great chin. He's very confident right now, and I think that's his number one asset, is that he's very confident and he possesses power from Alabama Hammer. Let me know what you think. Until next time, it's Pedro Justice.